Here's a simple and easy way to get great results from the declicker and voice denoiser in RX Elements. In my case, I'm using Adobe Audition, but you can use these plugins with just about any DAW out there. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do in the effects rack is to roll off the low end at 80 hertz because that will eliminate a lot of potential low frequency noise that's making it into my mic. And by doing that, I then give the denoiser an even easier time when it goes to work on identifying and removing any leftover noise. But before I get to the voice denoiser, I'm going to insert the declicker because, again, by doing that, I'm removing even more unwanted noise, even if it's just in the form of mouth clicks. Generally, there are two setups with the declicker that work really well. The first is to set the algorithm to multi-band random clicks, as you see here. And the sensitivity should be set to the default at 3.0. You can go to 4.0 if you really feel you need to, but I've done extensive testing with this plugin, and when it's pushed beyond 4.0, it can cause some anomalies, like dropped out K and T sounds. But give it a shot and see what works best for your voice. Now, if you find that this setup is cutting off the end of some words, then switch the algorithm to single band. Because even though the multi-band option works best for most people, every now and then, the single band setting just works better. Okay? So let me quickly show you what this plugin is removing. There's a checkbox right here that allows me to output the clicks instead of removing them. And even though I generally don't have much mouth noise, check this out. Kind of neat, but kind of gross at the same time, right? So if I don't have much mouth noise to begin with, what was that all about? Well, the plugin also removes sounds from moisture in the mouth, which is the majority of what we have here. But the human ear is used to that and doesn't identify it as a problem. It's really just the clicks we're after. With that said, when this plugin removes the clicks, the majority of moisture sounds are also removed, but it won't cause the voiceover to sound noticeably different if used correctly, so don't worry about that. All right, now on to the voice denoiser. This one is super simple. Just make sure it's set to adaptive mode and let it do its thing, because it really is very good at identifying the difference between noise and voice, and when used correctly, it won't affect the EQ print of the voice at all. But to be clear, when I say noise, I'm not talking about barking, sirens, and so on. This is more about computer fans, the self-noise of the mic, maybe some light noise from mechanical devices, and so on. So make sure you're voicing in a relatively quiet space to begin with before you commit to buying this plugin. Okay, so I'm going to copy and paste this voiceover. Then I'll run the rack I built on just one copy, and we'll compare the two. Okay, let's check the noise floor in the raw audio. In this case, I'm voicing in my control room instead of my booth, so I expect the noise floor to be a little higher than usual. And there you go. It's bottoming out somewhere around minus 63 dB. Okay, so now let's check the treated audio. And it looks like the noise floor is bottoming out right around minus 72 dB, which is a decrease of around 11 dB. So as you can see, it's very effective. And I could push the noise floor much lower with what's known as downward expansion, but we'll leave that for another video. All right, so there you go. Easy as that. I hope this video helped you in some way, and I'll see you in the next one.